you can do anything you set your mind to, YouTube. Don't let anybody tell you you're not good enough or that you can't. When it comes to a career, you want to be an astronaut? Then be an astronaut, you know? You want to be a rocket scientist? You want to work with animals? There's a bunch of awesome careers to choose from that make great money and help make you a productive member of society.
First off, I'd like to state we have an emergency. All the men on my marriage list have vagina butts so that they are unable to defecate. And this has been going on for over 2 weeks. And we need scientists out there who can help our nanotechnology research team come up with a way for my men to defecate so they can possibly by maybe letting them poop through your penis or maybe causing a lining to retract and expand when they poop through the vagina butt. Those were some of the ideas we had. But I'm certain you all, we have space age technology and you might be able to help them. This is an emergency. If they don't, some of these men, if they don't start defecating soon, they will die from, I think they call it blood poisoning, from getting germs into your bloodstream.
Oh yeah, like I'm some kind of science experiment, like I'm some kind of freak.
Excuse me being trans, and I'm like, yeah, but if I got some fake tits, I'd stop right there and that'd be the only surgery I would get. And then I'd never leave the house. I'd be sitting here in my apartment playing with my own boobies while I masturbate, like. But I'm like, no, I don't got the money to do that and I have no interest to do it. The only reason I would get fake boobies on myself is so I could have a pair to play with without someone being like, hey, motherfucker. Plus, I get so many progressive points for doing it, people would be like, oh my God, Cobra, you're so brave.
We need to get them. We need to get them and put them into treatment. This is an emergency. Before they do something where they're going to harm themselves or others, they're dangerous right now. They're insane. And treat it before they do something totally self-destructive. This isn't just a life and death emergency because of the inability to poop. I believe those men out there are dangerous to themselves and to others right now.
If there's nothing else that I agree with Eugenia Cuneo on, it's that doing a 5150 is not really the best way to do something. I don't know about y'all, but I've not had good experiences going inpatient. The choice is literally between a psych unit or prison. I would rather do something to get myself in prison. You don't understand the amount of fucking trauma that you come out of those places with. You go in trying to find help and you leave with more trauma. You leave with nightmares of people you don't know. Standing in your room and you're asleep and you just wake up and you see that person looking at you with his hand under his shirt and you know what he's doing. I don't know, maybe y'all have experienced other better psych units, but here in New Jersey, where I am, psych units are maximum security, you have no freedom, and you don't get to leave until they say you can.
If the bag is too full of crap or farts, essentially it could pop. It could pop. Knock on wood, has never happened to me. I have never had my bag pop. Thank God, thank the good Lord, thanks to the acid, the gas cigar.
But one thing that saved my life was this simple surgery that I had. It's about the size of a silver dollar. They put it in your chest. It's like a generator, and it generates an electric shock, and it has a lead wire that goes up the side of the neck, okay? It basically gives your brain an electric shock every 3 minutes.
Of Gale. What's the shit about constipated? I fucking make my own human centipede. And a human centipede with the young couples. They're gonna eat ass and shit.